A group of Arctic whales living so far south is highly unusual. Olga believes that these whales aren't migrating here, but might actually be the remnants of a group of bowheads distinct from their Arctic cousins. Olga may have identified a completely unique group of bowhead whales.
It's an isolated population, but we think happened during the last glacial period. All whales were pushed down south with the ice age. And this is when they occupied the Okhotsk Sea.
So they didn't move north as the Earth warmed from the end of the last ice age?
No, they stayed here.
What is your guess on how many bowheads are in this population?
We think it's about 200 whales, maybe just a little bit more.
Wow, that's fascinating.
This tiny, isolated population could have been separated from the Arctic bowheads for over 10,000 years. But now, these mysterious whales are under attack. Olga shows me some shocking footage of an event that she witnessed that might explain the strange behavior in the bay. Killer whales.
Oh, jeez.
This is the first footage ever captured of killer whales attacking bowheads. And Olga has noticed something unusual about the technique.
Ramming. Here you can see they're hitting in one place.
So they're breaking its ribs
down.
Jeez.
See this? This is
where
they are ramming. Like you can tell the ribs are broken. The whale is trying hard to get closer to shore.
Yeah.
To shallow water. And they're pushing it away. They're herding it away from shore.
Killer whales are well known for their sophisticated hunting techniques. And this is not an isolated incident. Olga has seen this many times.
And actually, they come like every other day.
On my mission to swim with a bowhead whale, I've stepped into a serious conflict between two ocean giants. The number of attacks on this small population of bowheads could be a serious threat to their survival. Olga is determined to prove scientifically that there are no more than a few hundred individual whales in this isolated population, and to have them officially reclassified as highly endangered. For this, she needs a revolutionary technique for collecting a lot of DNA samples.
This idea may sound crazy, but I really want to try to biopsy them from the drone. To make a dart, which we can drop from the drone with some kind of release mechanism.
One of the few talents that I have is flying drones over whales. This is something I have a really large number of hours doing.
Yeah. Patrick, that's why I need you.
Yeah. All right.
Help me.
I'm happy to help.
This is my hope.
The idea is to drop a weighted dart with a metal tip. This in no way harms the whale. At 20 inches, bowhead's blubber is the thickest in the world.
Okay, go!
First, some target practice.
It's ambitious, to say the least, to try to design a dart to hang from a drone that the drone is not designed to carry, and then to maneuver it into the right position, release it, have it drop onto the top of the whale, take a skin sample out, float, and then be able to collect it while retaining the skin sample inside the dart. All right, I see the circles. When I say go, you hit the button.
Okay.
There's probably a reason why no one's been successful. No one's even tried it as far as I'm aware. Okay, go. There's ones with long shafts and short tips. There's ones with long tips and short shafts. So we gotta test them all to see which one lands the flattest. I think it's gonna be an incredible challenge, but I think it's absolutely possible. And if it works, it will give scientists a whole new tool to collect DNA data from whales. So there's a lot of pressure to get this right.
We set off in Olga's boat. It's one thing dropping those darts on the beach. Quite another dropping it from a boat onto a moving whale. It's critical that I can shield the glare of the sun off my monitor screen so I can see my exact position.
Just getting to the whale now. Okay, stand by, I'm right over top. Okay, just give me a second. Drop. Got it, direct hit. Anything?
Absolutely nothing.
I wonder if it hit it and came out.
No one said it would be easy.
Yeah, if it were easy, it would have been done before, so we knew it would be a challenge.
But now the whales have come right into the shore. And I can send the drone up from the beach.
This could work, they're coming our way. Yeah, I see it. What are they doing? Two have really turned.
The whales start to behave strangely.
Oh, they're bumping into each other.
I have no idea what's happening, but this could be our best opportunity.
Tell me when.
I'm over the third one now, it just turned. Okay, now, drop. Just hit it.
Now it's a race to retrieve the dart before we lose sight of it.
Orca! There's a killer whale!
Now I understand why the bowheads were panicking. I watch as they stick close to the shore. On this occasion, the killer whales leave and head up the coast. I follow them with the drone. Then they disappear.
I looked up and the whales were panicking and I was trying to decide, should I back the paddleboard up, should I get out of the way? They panicked.
Well,
my first priority was picking up your dart. My next priority was survival.
Thank you, my friend.
Because then the whales were charging towards me and I put the dart in a safe place and then I backed up to get out of the way of the whales.
Good. Let me check. Yeah. I was really, really glad that the dart actually worked. There was a piece of skin. But the most important thing was that what we have is more than enough for genetic analysis. Another thing which is very important is that the whale didn't seem to be bothered at all. It didn't startle, it didn't move away quickly, it didn't actually change this behavior that gives us hope for getting more samples like this.
With this innovation in DNA sampling, Olga is one step closer to proving the highly endangered status of these special whales. And her dream of having them fully protected may soon become a reality. I'm very proud to have been a part of that.
I'm not a scientist, I don't have a PhD in anything, and yet just being passionate and eager and willing, just someone like me can come out here and do something that really advances the science and understanding of these animals. It's an incredible feeling.
But I've come here to get in the water with a bowhead whale. I had no idea killer whales were such a big part of their lives. I've never seen anything like this before.